I will be taking a COVID-19 test and I will explain it with my medical illustration. Hello scientists, welcome to Drobal Med. I'm about to head to the Schiphol Airport in Amsterdam to take my COVID-19 test because I'm traveling to Berlin to visit a group of neuroscientists who are also artists. And they are having an exhibition in Berlin, and so I'm going to interview them. However, now the Netherlands, this Amsterdam area, is considered a risk area by the German government.
Yes, yes, we can hear you.
Okay.
So in order for me to travel to Germany without a quarantine, then I have to take a corona test. That's why I'm doing it through the KOM health service to test if I have corona.
Okay, I'm gonna do two tests, one in your nose and one in your throat. Okay. I'm gonna start with your throat.
Yeah.
So lean backwards.
Like that.
Okay, open your mouth, stick out your tongue. You say ah.
Ah.
Okay. One.
Okay. Oh. That was quite uncomfortable. In the footage, you saw that there was a swab poking into my nose, and that is called a nasopharyngeal swab. It is the standard procedure of taking a COVID-19 sample. I also have drawn a medical illustration to explain how the swab is done. I will explain what happened to me with my own illustration. So as you can see from the animation I made here, that the swab will be traveling through the nasal cavity and then reach all the way to the posterior nasal pharynx. And they will take a few turns over there. It's very uncomfortable. The samples can contain the possible COVID-19 genetic materials, and then they will do an RT-PCR test. RT-PCR is a technique that can amplify the nucleus material within your sample. So in this case, it is amplifying the RNA of the COVID-19 virus, because COVID-19 is an RNA virus. The RT means reverse transcription. That means converting RNA into cDNA and then amplify that cDNA. I will show you the mechanism of this RT-PCR procedure in my follow-up video about my COVID-19 test result. And so make sure you subscribe so you can see that video when it's uploaded. In the footage, you saw the nurse also took an oropharyngeal test. That's how the KOM health service works, that they take both the nasal and the oropharyngeal test. I think this is just a way for them to make sure that they would be able to have sufficient samples to have the test, and they can cross-check the result. This information about the corona test that I'm talking about are based on these two videos. One is from the New England Journal of Medicine, and the other one is from MBOS. You can go check them out if you want to know more details about the corona test. So I should be getting the test result within 48 to 36 hours, and that will be just about one day before my departure to Berlin. It cost 145 euro to do this test for specifically for traveling. In the Netherlands, if you have a symptom, then you can test it for free at their public health service. It's really just that, because I don't have symptoms. So it's a privilege situation that I need to pay for my COVID-19 test. In the meantime, I'll tell you a little bit about the neuroscientists I'm going to visit. Tatiana and Sharia are two neuroscientists who study at the Charité Medical Center in Berlin. It is one of the biggest medical centers in Germany. They have formed like an art foundation, which is called the EDGE Neuroscience and Art Foundation. These neuroscientists, they happen to be artists themselves, or they are also art enthusiasts, and they have created a lot of artwork that's based on their knowledge about neuroscience and just and also their experience as neuroscientists. They hold exhibition every year, and this October they're holding two exhibitions in Berlin. And I'm having a Zoom call with Tatiana and Sharia, and I will let them to tell you more about these exhibitions. There's so many exciting videos that are coming out. I link them all here so you can find them easily. Make sure to subscribe to Drawball Med to follow up with all these new contents, and I look forward to seeing you in these future videos.